So now let's discuss the rapid MCQ series of corticosteroids now. Now remember, corticosteroids are the steroidal hormones which are synthesized from adrenal cortex. They are synthesized from adrenal cortex and they are steroidal hormones. That is why they are known as corticosteroids. Remember, they produce effect inside the cell by acting on intracytoplasmic receptor. Okay, intracytoplasmic receptor. Now these corticosteroids, they are mainly of two types. First is glucocorticoid. Second is mineralocorticoid. Now the glucocorticoid which is produced in our body is hydrocortisone. This is a natural drug. It is also known as cortisol. And the mineralocorticoid which is produced in the body is aldosterone. Okay, but remember, mineralocorticoid has little bit of glucocorticoid activity and glucocorticoid also has little bit of mineralocorticoid activity. But their predominant action is glucocorticoid. Its main action is to maintain immunity. It suppresses immunity of the body and it decreases inflammation in the body. Okay, and the main function of mineralocorticoid is to cause sodium retention. Remember, aldosterone acts on cortical portion of collecting duct of kidney and it reabsorbs sodium back into the blood and it causes sodium retention, thereby it causes potassium and hydrogen loss. So the level of sodium increases, hence the blood pressure of the person increases. Okay, BP increases. So this is a basic overview. So let's talk about the first question. Compared to hydrocortisone, maximum glucocorticoid activity is seen with. So now let's talk about certain synthetic glucocorticoid as well as mineralocorticoid. Let's compare them. So we take hydrocortisone is our standard. We assume that hydrocortisone or cortisol, it has 1:1 glucocorticoid to mineralocorticoid activity. And let's assume the dose to be 20 milligram. It's a short acting drug. Then we have made a synthetic analog known as cortisone, which was the first synthetic glucocorticoid to be made. As we can see, its glucocorticoid activity is 0.8. It is the least potent glucocorticoid we have. It requires the highest dose, that is 25% times more, that is 25 milligram. Then as we go downwards, you're seeing the glucocorticoid activity of these drugs are keep on increasing. Prednisone and prednisolone 4 times more potent, methylprednisolone 5 times more potent, deflazacort and triamcinolone, they are pure glucocorticoid without any mineralocorticoid activity. They are intermediate acting. Then we have dexamethasone and betamethasone. They are the most potent glucocorticoid we have with zero mineralocorticoid activity. And they are the pure glucocorticoid also. They are the longest acting also, that is dexa and betamethasone. Then as we compare more of a mineralocorticoid, aldosterone is the natural mineralocorticoid, but remember it is the most potent. It has 3000 times mineralocorticoid activity, but it is not used. Then we have docadeoxycorticosterone acetate. It's a pure mineralocorticoid, but the drug which we use as a mineralocorticoid replacement is fludrocortisone. Okay, because it can be given orally as well as IV. So these are the various special points. So least potent glucocorticoid is cortisone. Most potent, longest acting and pure glucocorticoids are dexa and betamethasone. Dexamethasone overall is most potent. Betamethasone overall is the longest acting. Now hydrocortisone, remember it has both glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid activity. Hence it is the drug of choice for adrenal insufficiency. When the adrenal cortex is not producing glucocorticoid as well as mineralocorticoid, then we give hydrocortisone. Now most potent mineralocorticoid is aldosterone, pure mineralocorticoid is doca, and most common replacement we use fludrocortisone. Okay, and it is given in cases of fludrocortisone is the drug of choice in hypotension. In adrenal insufficiency, it is add-on drug to hydrocortisone and congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. Let's solve the question now. So compared to hydrocortisone, maximum glucocorticoid activity we have already seen is with dexamethasone, 25 times more. So dexamethasone and betamethasone are the most potent glucocorticoid agent. Now long-term administration of glucocorticoid causes all of the following except. Now remember, long-term administration of glucocorticoid causes a syndrome of side effect known as Cushing syndrome. It causes Cushing syndrome. So long-term administration of glucocorticoid causes Cushing syndrome. Let's see the features of Cushing syndrome now. It's a very important slide for you. So adverse effect of glucocorticoids, corticosteroid is known as Cushing syndrome. So C stands for the mnemonic is corticosteroid. Cushingoid features like moon face, buffalo hemp and orange on stick appearance, that is central obesity. It is due to redistribution of fat on face, interscapular area, that is why buffalo, and central obesity, orange on stick. It causes osteoporosis. Remember, corticosteroids are catabolic hormone. It causes breakdown of proteins in the all organs. So it will lead to osteoporosis, breakdown of fat, which will deposit in other places, lipodystrophy, thinning of skin because of breakdown of collagen in the skin. It will lead to easy bruisability and infection known as folliculitis. Infections, it can cause cataract on systemic use. On topical use, remember, corticosteroid causes glaucoma. On systemic use, oral or IV, it causes cataract. It causes avascular necrosis or osteonecrosis of femur neck. Stress ulcer, telangiectasia because of thinning of skin, euphoria and Frank's psychosis, retarded growth, low potassium or hypokalemia and hypertension because of mineralocorticoid action. It causes breakdown of glucose, gluconeogenesis, which leads to hyperglycemia. Hence, corticosteroids should not be given in diabetic patient, and long-term administration of glucocorticoid leads to negative feedback and suppression of ACTH. Hence, we should never withdraw corticosteroids suddenly. It will lead to sudden adrenal crisis or adrenal failure. Okay, so adrenal failure, remember, occurs due to chronic corticosteroid therapy. Due to chronic corticosteroid therapy, we assume that if 5 mg of prednisolone is given daily or equivalent amount of other corticosteroids are given daily for more than 2 to 3 weeks, it will lead to adrenal atrophy. It is mainly seen with oral corticosteroid. And these steroids, more than 2 to 3 weeks if you are given, do not withdraw them suddenly. We should taper them gradually. Now, what is the alternative? The alternative is, if you have to give them for long term, we can give pulse therapy. That means we can give on alternative day or by giving a break in between. Pulse therapy means on first day we will give, second day we will not give glucocorticoid, because so that adrenal suppression should not occur. The drug of choice for pulse therapy, we use either short or intermediate acting glucocorticoid, that is methylprednisolone. Long acting should not be given as a pulse therapy. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. So let's talk about these drugs. So it causes proximal myopathy. So answer is absolutely true, because it leads to breakdown of protein in muscles. It causes hyperkalemia. Glucocorticoid, it's false. Remember, glucocorticoid causes hypokalemia because of their mineralocorticoid action. They cause sodium retention and potassium loss. So they rather cause hypokalemia, not hyperkalemia. Okay, hypertension, yes, because of sodium retention. Cataract, yes, due to systemic use. So the answer is they do not cause hyperkalemia. All of the following therapeutic use of corticosteroids are appropriate except. Now the first question is, beclomethasone is given in bronchial asthma. It's absolutely true. We have discussed in asthma. It is the standard inhalational agent for asthma. Because it is given in inflammatory condition or hypersensitive condition, glucocorticoid reduces inflammation. Cortisone for Cushing syndrome. Remember, cortisone is a glucocorticoid. It itself causes Cushing syndrome. So B is a false statement. Prednisolone for, again, an autoimmune condition. True. Dexamethasone for reducing intracranial tension. True, because it reduces edema. So the answer is B. All of the following are topical steroid except. Okay. So the answer out here is prednisolone. So let's talk about certain topical steroids. So these are the examples of topical corticosteroids. So topical corticosteroid or glucocorticoid, they can be given by ointment. It is the most potent preparation. Why? It is highly lipid soluble. It can penetrate easily. It is given in dry and scaly lesion, cream for exudative lesion because it evaporates, spray for hairy region. The most potent glucocorticoid is betamethasone dipropionate. These four are most potent topical glucocorticoid. That is betamethasone dipropionate, clobetazole propionate, halobetazole propionate and diflurazone diacetate. Medium is triamcinolone, least potent is dexan hydrocortisone. Till now, prednisolone was not available as a topical glucocorticoid, but recently it has been available. So it's an old question which was asked. You will go by the answer prednisolone. Now, corticosteroid with maximum sodium retaining potential. In other words, it is asking the corticosteroid with maximum mineralocorticoid activity. Mineralocorticoid activity is always and always, we have already discussed, is aldosterone. Okay. The answer is aldosterone. Aldosterone is the most potent mineralocorticoid. We have already discussed. The primary goal of glucocorticoid treatment in rheumatoid arthritis is it has anti-inflammatory action. So the answer is it suppresses inflammation and improve functional capacity. So glucocorticoid, remember, they are anti-inflammatory. Okay. And they have immunosuppressive property. So they reduce the inflammation which is seen in autoimmune conditions like rheumatoid arthritis. Which of the following drugs causes osteoporosis in long term? The answer is corticosteroid, prednisolone. Okay. Which of the following is not a steroid? The answer is, if you are finding a word steroid, they are synthesized from cholesterol. See the word O. Relaxin, remember, is not a corticosteroid. It is a peptide hormone which is responsible for relaxation of uterus during labor. The most potent topical glucocorticoid is, we have already discussed, the answer among them is cut this valerate and write dipropionate. So the answer among them is betamethasone dipropionate. Okay. Now, a 35-year-old male with a long-standing disseminated tuberculosis presents with emaciated or weight loss state or catabolic state. BP is low, as you are seeing, BP is low. Pulse volume is 100 beats per minute. Pulse is 100 beats per minute, which is normal. Diffuse hyperpigmentation of the skin and hand increase. So it is due to increase in melanin. And remember, melanin is produced by, stimulated by ACTH hormone, okay, by pro-opiomelanocortin. Serum sodium is low and serum potassium is high. So can we say the patient is having hypotension due to low sodium? Okay, low sodium. So can we say that the level of aldosterone is less or the level of corticosteroid is less? Because of low level of corticosteroid in that person, there is no negative feedback on ACTH and CRH hormone. So the level of CRH and ACTH increases, which increases melanin production. So the answer for this question is the patient is having adrenal insufficiency. So you will come to the diagnosis, adrenal insufficiency. And the drug of choice for adrenal insufficiency, give glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid replacement. The drug which has both glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid activity is hydrocortisone. So the answer for this question is the patient is having adrenal insufficiency, start intravenous corticosteroid. So the answer out here will be C. Okay. So the patient is having adrenal insufficiency, start intravenous corticosteroid. Now, most potent topical corticosteroid overall is betamethasone dipropionate. Okay, dipropionate. If dipropionate is not given, then you will go by the answer triamcinolone acetonide. It is medium potent. Okay, it is medium potent. Vitamin beneficial in combination of in the treatment of osteoporosis. Remember, apart from vitamin D, vitamin K is also required for bone formation because vitamin K forms a protein known as osteocalcin. Osteocalcin stimulate osteoblast, hence the answer is vitamin K. Remember, vitamin K deficiency also leads to osteoporosis. Which of the following is not a treatment of osteoporosis? Remember, the answer is androgens. We don't give androgens in osteoporosis. Now, long-acting glucocorticoid is, longest is dexamethasone. We have already seen it's the longest-acting glucocorticoid. Okay. Which advice would you give to a patient who is to be treated with bisphosphonates? So bisphosphonate question is of question of osteoporosis. Remember, bisphosphonate should be given before meals, before the glass of water. So please refer to the topic of osteoporosis. We have discussed this question. Now the most potent glucocorticoid is clobetazole propionate cream. We have already discussed this answer. Okay, clobetazole propionate 0.5% cream. Which of the following is true of adrenal suppression due to steroid therapy? Now, steroid suppression, remember, it is more seen with oral as compared to inhalational. So can we say, let's see that list again of adrenal suppression due to corticosteroid. It is seen due to chronic steroid use. Okay, it is mainly seen with oral, less with inhaled. It is associated with adrenal atrophy. Sudden withdrawal should not be given. And the treatment is pulse therapy by methylprednisolone, not by long-acting dexa and betamethasone. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. So it is not associated with adrenal atrophy. It's absolutely false. It is associated with adrenal atrophy. It is less likely to be occur in patient of receiving inhaled corticosteroid. It's absolutely true. It is more seen with oral, less seen with inhaled. It should be expected in anyone receiving more than 5 mg of prednisolone daily. It's absolutely true. But it should be more than 2 to 3 weeks. And following cessation, the stress response normalizes after 8 weeks. Yes, it takes around 8 weeks to normalize. So, the true statement is B, C, and D. It is less likely to be occurring in inhaled steroid as compared to oral steroid. It should be expected, true, more than 5 mg, and D. So B, C, and D are the correct answer. Now, drugs causing Addison's disease are. Now, drugs which causes Addison's disease, remember, they inhibit adrenal, cortico, steroid synthesis. So the drug which inhibit corticosteroid synthesis in adrenal gland are, the mnemonic is make my trip. Okay, the mnemonic is make my trip, that is mitotane, aminoglutethimide, ketoconazole, etomidate, metirapone, and trilose chain. So these drugs, they cause Addison's disease or chronic adrenal insufficiency, and among them the answer out here is A and B. Okay, now let's come to the question number 19. Aldosterone is known to cause sodium retention. Its sodium retention action comes on which part of the kidney? Try to recall, it is the cortical part of collecting duct. The cortical portion of collecting duct, remember, aldosterone acts. Cortical portion of collecting duct. What acts? Aldosterone. But remember, in medullary portion of collecting duct, medullary portion of collecting duct, remember, ADH hormone acts, antidiuretic hormone. It causes water retention. It causes sodium retention, aldosterone. And ADH causes water retention through medullary portion. Now, hydrocortisone has an anti-inflammatory agent because of induction of synthesis of which protein? The answer for this question is D, that is lipocortin. Now, remember, glucocorticoid, they increase the synthesis of lipocortin, which is also known as annexins. And this annexins inhibit phospholipase A2 enzyme. Because phospholipase A2 causes inflammation by formation of prostaglandin and thromboxane. So the answer out here is lipocortin. So let's see what is the mechanism by which glucocorticoid produces immunosuppressive action or anti-inflammatory action. So this is the various anti-inflammatory effect of glucocorticoid. They reduce the production of interleukin 1, 5, 6 and TNF-alpha. They increase the production of annexins or lipocortins, which are anti-inflammatory, and interleukin 10, which inhibits phospholipase A2. That is why arachidonic acid will not be broken down, it's a phospholipid, into prostaglandin and leukotriene, which causes inflammation. It decreases vascular permeability and it reduces the number of lymphocyte, eosinophils and basophil. Okay, so the answer is lipocortin. Which of the following disorders is not aggravated not aggravated by corticosteroid therapy. Remember, corticosteroids, they are the drug of choice for congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Why? Because there is adrenal insufficiency. Because there is adrenal insufficiency, and corticosteroids are given in congenital adrenal hyperplasia. In diabetes mellitus, it's contraindicated because they cause hyperkalemia. Hypertension, they themselves cause hypertension because of sodium retention, and they cause stress peptic ulcer because of reduction of prostaglandin in stomach. So the answer is A. It is given in congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Now, toxic effect of long-term administration of glucocorticoid, try to recall the slide of Cushing syndrome. It causes hepatotoxicity, false. It causes osteoporosis, true. Precocious puberty is not the function of corticosteroid, it's the function of sex steroid. Lupus-like syndrome, false. Remember, they are the treatment of SLE or lupus-like syndrome. So the answer is osteoporosis. Now, Shanti has been diagnosed with a brain tumor. Would you prefer to give dexa or betamethasone over hydrocortisone in cerebral edema? Because dexamethasone and betamethasone have zero or no mineralocorticoid or sodium retention property. No sodium retention. Because if sodium will be retained, it will rather increase ICT. Intracranial tension is more increased by mineralocorticoid. So the answer out here is they do not cause sodium and water retention. They are pure glucocorticoids. Okay. Now, long-term steroid therapy can lead to suppression of hypothalamic pituitary axis. Thereby, it suppresses HCTH level. It overcome by alternative day. Alternative day, we have discussed, is known as pulse therapy. And the drug of choice among glucocorticoid for pulse therapy was methylprednisolone or short-acting drug. But remember, in pulse therapy, we cannot give long-acting glucocorticoid like betamethasone because they act for more than 2 days. Okay? Because they act for more than 36 to 48 hours. So their effect will remain if you will not give on an alternative day. Most potent mineralocorticoid, aldosterone. Okay, but it is not used. Systemic steroids can cause all of the following except glaucoma. Remember, glaucoma is seen by topical use. Okay, topical. Steroids are contraindicated in all except diabetes. Yes, it is contraindicated. They cause hyperglycemia. True. Peptic ulcer, true. Remember, they are the drug of choice for the treatment of dermatitis or eczematous skin lesion. Addison's disease, drug have to be given. Remember, in Addison's disease, there is chronic adrenal insufficiency. That means there is decrease in level of glucocorticoid as well as mineralocorticoid. So which corticosteroid has both glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid activity? That was hydrocortisone. The drug of choice for Addison's disease is hydrocortisone. So let's see the treatment of Addison's disease. The treatment of Addison's disease is, or chronic adrenal insufficiency. So this is the treatment of adrenal insufficiency or adrenal failure, which is also seen in cases of congenital CAH or thyroid storm also. So remember, if it is acute, give intravenous drug. If it is chronic, developing slowly, give oral drug. We start with hydrocortisone because it has both glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid activity. While we can give dopamine in acute to suddenly increase the blood pressure and fludrocortisone in chronic to slowly increase the blood pressure because fludrocortisone is a mineralocorticoid. But drug of choice in both of them in adrenal insufficiency is hydrocortisone. Okay, hydrocortisone. Glucocorticoid with mineralocorticoid action is the best among option among them is cortisol. Remember, all other corticosteroids are pure glucocorticoid with no mineralocorticoid action. Triamcinolone, betamethasone and dexamethasone are pure glucocorticoid. So the answer is cortisol. So let's see that list again. So cortisol or hydrocortisone has both glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid activity. If you see triamcinolone in black, it has zero mineralocorticoid action. Dexa and betamethasone also have zero mineralocorticoid action. They are pure glucocorticoid. Okay. Now, at same concentration of steroid, the most potent is always and always, we have discussed, ointment. Ointment is the most potent because it is the most lipid soluble. It can penetrate the areas easily. Okay. Now, steroids are indicated in all of the following forms of tuberculosis except. So let's see corticosteroids in infection. As we know that corticosteroids are suppresses immunity, would you like to give them in infection? The answer is still yes. Corticosteroids are still given in certain infections. Those infections which are very life-threatening. So the in infections we give corticosteroid like all life-threatening infection. Rather we increase the dose. If a person is already on corticosteroid, we don't stop corticosteroid in infection. We rather increase the dose, like in meningitis, neurocysticercosis, pneumocystis carinii in HIV, septic shock, leprosy reaction and Bell's palsy. Most commonly we use prednisolone, but in certain infection, corticosteroids should not be given. The first is intestinal TB and certain other forms of TB like ileocecal TB, disseminated TB and primary progressive TB. Why not in intestinal TB? It leads to silent perforation. And second is herpes corneal infection or corneal ulcer known as herpes keratitis. These are the two infections where we don't give corticosteroid during their infection. It can lead to irreversible opacification. Okay, so the answer out here you will find is ileocecal TB because it increases the risk of silent perforation. Because corticosteroid, they suppress healing or fibrosis. If fibrosis or healing will not occur, the intestine will perforate. Remember that it is mandatory to give them in meningitis, pericarditis and adrenal involvement or adrenal insufficiency because they prevent stricture or fibrosis. All of the following correct about steroids except, which is incorrect. So the answer for this question 32 is it inhibits the release of arachidonic acid from vessel wall through the action of phospholipase A2. True. It inhibits phospholipase A2. It binds to plasma membrane receptor. No, it binds to intracytoplasmic receptor. So the answer is false. It rather binds to intracytoplasmic receptor. Steroids, they have intracytoplasmic receptor. It inhibits vascular permeability. True. It inhibits increased glucose synthesis in the liver. Yes, through gluconeogenesis. So the answer is B. Glucocorticoid have proved useful effect in the treatment of. Remember, glucocorticoid have been approved in the treatment of chemotherapy induced nausea and vomiting. Okay. Chemotherapy induced nausea and vomiting, we prefer to give dexamethasone. Because dexamethasone suppresses inflammation, inflammatory mediators, they go to CTZ area of the brain. Through inflammation, they cause vomiting. Okay. So it is given. The drug prednisolone is known to be a powerful anti-inflammatory agent. It is due to the action on which enzyme phospholipase A2. So glucocorticoid, they inhibit phospholipase A2 enzyme. Arachidonic acid will not be broken down into prostaglandin and leukotrienes. Which of the following steroid is preferred in high dose for intravenous corticosteroid pulse therapy? If pulse therapy word will come, blindly mark the answer as methylprednisolone. Okay, pulse therapy, methylprednisolone. So it generally it is given for starting or induction of treatment of autoimmune disease. In the treatment of congenital adrenal hyperplasia, due to lack of 21 beta hydroxylase, the purpose of administered synthetic glucocorticoid is. So let's see the treatment of congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Remember, in congenital adrenal hyperplasia, there is the most common enzyme deficiency is 21 beta hydroxylase. So all the cholesterol will be converted into androgen or testosterone. Glucocorticoid is not formed and mineralocorticoid is not formed. Everything will be converted into testosterone. So in fetus, a female fetus will be converted into a male fetus, male phenotype, which is known as hermaphroditism. So if a fetus comes, a pregnant female comes, we give dexamethasone. Dexamethasone is the most potent glucocorticoid. It will inhibit ACTH hormone, so the testosterone will not be synthesized. But if a child is born, due to deficiency of glucocorticoid and mineralocorticoid in them, a born child will have adrenal insufficiency. To save a child, we give hydrocortisone. Okay, so in fetus, we give dexamethasone to suppress ACTH. If a child is born, we give hydrocortisone for adrenal insufficiency. This is the treatment of congenital adrenal hyperplasia. So can you tell me What is the purpose of giving glucocorticoid in congenital adrenal hyperplasia? So the answer is to suppress ACTH secretion in fetus. Okay, and the drug of choice is dexamethasone. A patient, Dharampal, has been diagnosed to have a bronchial asthma. He started on oral prednisolone 20 mg per day and inhaled salbutamol as required. Patient developed chest infection. Which of the following measure do you take? Remember, generally corticosteroid, they cause infection. But if infection has occurred, remember, don't stop corticosteroid. Rather, increase the dose of corticosteroid because they help in fighting the stress. It's a stress hormone. It helps in fighting with the stress. Okay. So the answer out here is C. Either no change or increase the dose of prednisolone. Okay. A 50-year-old man with advanced tuberculosis have developed sign of acute adrenal insufficiency. The patient should be treated with, remember, acute adrenal insufficiency word has come, blindly mark the answer as hydrocortisone. But hydrocortisone is also known as cortisol. If it is still the BP is low, add fludrocortisone. So we have already seen the treatment of acute adrenal insufficiency. The answer is C. Which of the following is not true about beclomethasone? Okay. Now, beclomethasone is indicated for chronic use in asthma. Yes, it's absolutely true. It is an inhaled steroid. It's absolutely true. It is effective in acute asthma. Remember, it's false. In acute asthma, there is no role of beclomethasone, corticosteroid. Okay, it predisposed or decreased the immunity, thereby it caused fungal infection. It's absolutely true. So corticosteroid, remember, in asthma, they are for prophylaxis of asthma. Okay, prophylaxis of asthma. Now, all are the, because they are not bronchodilator, all are the side effects of corticosteroid except the answer is photosensitivity. They cause skin atrophy, telangiectasia and folliculitis. Okay, because of damage of proteins, collagen protein breakdown in skin. Compared to hydrocortisone, maximum glucocorticoid action was with dexamethasone. Corticosteroids causes all of the following except muscle hypertrophy, false. Remember, corticosteroids are catabolic hormone. They cause muscle atrophy. Peptic ulcer, true. Psychosis, true. Suppression of adrenal axis, true. So the answer is muscle atrophy. Which of the following antifungal drug can be used in the treatment of Cushing syndrome? So Cushing syndrome means there is increase in corticosteroid. So can you tell me which corticosteroid, which antifungal drug reduces adrenal hormone synthesis? I told you, make my trip. The drug was ketoconazole. So go by the answer, ketoconazole. So I'll show you the treatment of Cushing syndrome. What are the drugs we use for the treatment of Cushing syndrome? So these drugs which are used in the treatment of Cushing syndrome, they are known as anti-glucocorticoids. So the first drug that will suppress the production of ACTH is octreotide or pasireotide. They are somatostatin hormone which suppresses. The drug which inhibits steroid hormone synthesis in adrenal gland is, they are known as medical adrenalectomy also, that is make my trip, metirapone, aminoglutethimide, one antifungal drug ketoconazole, one general anesthetic agent etomidate, mitotane and trilostane. And the drug that will block the receptors of glucocorticoid, that is mifepristone. So these are the drugs which are used in the treatment of Cushing syndrome. The antifungal out here is ketoconazole. Okay. All of the following glucocorticoid lack mineralocorticoid activity except the answer out here was prednisolone. So other drugs are pure glucocorticoid. Remember, recall the list we have discussed. Okay. So all are the side effects of steroid except hypotension. Remember, corticosteroid, they rather cause hypertension because of sodium retention. Which of the following is used for medical adrenalectomy? Try to remember that mnemonic, make my trip. The answer was mitotane. Okay. Side effects of steroids are all except they cause hypoglycemia, false. They rather cause hyperglycemia. they rather cause hyperglycemia. Why they cause hyperglycemia? Because in liver they cause gluconeogenesis. Because of gluconeogenesis, they cause hyperglycemia. Hypertension, true. Psychosis, true. Growth retardation, true. Because they are catabolic hormones. So the answer is hypoglycemia. In which of the following disease corticosteroids are indicated? Osteoporosis, false. They rather cause osteoporosis. Peptic ulcer, false. Intestinal TB, false. They cause silent perforation. They are the drug of choice for collagen vascular disease like SLE, polyarthritis nodosa, systemic sclerosis or scleroderma, etc. Corticosteroids are the drug of choice for collagen vascular disease. All of the following are the side effects of steroid except hyperglycemia, true. Infection, true. Peptic ulcer, true. The answer is osteomalacia. Remember, they don't cause osteomalacia. They rather cause osteoporosis. They don't cause osteomalacia. They cause osteoporosis. Now, anti-inflammatory action of steroid is due to inhibition of breakdown of which of the following? Breakdown of phospholipids. Okay, they inhibit phospholipase A2. Hence, the phospholipids from the cell membrane will not be broken down into arachidonic acid. So, the answer is breakdown of phospholipids. Okay, so they inhibit the breakdown of phospholipids. So, remember this part. Now, the next question is asking, which of the following can occur as a side effect of steroid due to its mineralocorticoid component? Mineralocorticoid component comes hypertension due to sodium retention. So, mineralocorticoid component causes hypertension. Which of the following has least mineralocorticoid activity? The answer out here is methylprednisolone. Okay. Cortisol, glucocorticoid to mineralocorticoid activity 1:1. Prednisolone 4:0.8. Methylprednisolone 0.5 around. Fludrocortisone 0.5 to 150. So the answer is methylprednisolone. So chronic use of which of the following medication is most likely to cause osteoporosis? Try to find a corticosteroid. Prednisolone. Okay. Prednisolone. Which of the following drugs can be used for the treatment of postmenopausal osteoporosis except thyroxine? Remember, thyroxine itself causes osteoporosis. So bisphosphonate, alendronate is used. Teriparatide, which is a parathyroid hormone analog, calcium is also given. Mitirapon. So make my trip, mitirapon is. So let's talk about these how adrenal gland synthesizes corticosteroid, and make my trip, mitirapon like drug, how they inhibit. So remember, corticosteroids, they are synthesized from cholesterol. First of all, cholesterol is converted into pregnenolone. It is inhibited by aminoglutathione. Then pregnenolone, it is converted into progesterone by 3-beta-hydroxylase. Three word is coming. Remember a word, tri. Trilose chain inhibit 3-beta-hydroxylase. It inhibits it. Then progesterone is converted into 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone. So 17-alpha-hydroxylase is inhibited by ketoconazole. Then 17-alpha-hydroxyprogesterone is converted into deoxycorticosterone by 21-beta-hydroxylase. Deoxycorticosterone acetate, corticosterone is converted into corticosterone by 11-beta-hydroxylase. Most of the drugs, they inhibit 11-beta-hydroxylase. That is mitirapon, mitotane, etomidate and ketoconazole. And then in adrenal gland, respective aldosterone and hydrocortisone are synthesized. So mitirapon, mitotane, they inhibit 11-beta-hydroxylase enzyme. So the answer out here is 11-beta-hydroxylase. So mitirapon inhibit 11-beta-hydroxylase. Which type of cataract is caused by systemic use of corticosteroid? The characteristic cataract caused by systemic use of corticosteroid is posterior subcapsular cataract. So suppose this is the lens, this is the eye, they cause here posterior subcapsular cataract. Posterior subcapsular cataract is caused by glucocorticoids. Steroids are contraindicated in. Now steroids, remember, they are given in inflammation, anterior uveitis, they are very important drug. They are given in allergic rhinitis or spring catarrh, true. They are given in inflammation, episcleritis. So wherever the inflammation is coming, remember, we give them. They are given in herpetic corneal ulcer, we have discussed. We don't give in TB and herpetic corneal ulcer because in herpetic corneal ulcer, it can lead to permanent opacification of cornea. In chronic simple glaucoma, yes, it can be given. So the answer is corneal ulcer. Okay. Corneal ulcers. Okay. Remember this part. Now, which of the following glucocorticoid receptor blocker? So the answer was mifepristone. Mifepristone is also known as RU486. Okay. So this is all about the corticosteroids. Thank you very much for the complete video subscription. You can see the complete videos by Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series for the whole conceptual videos. Thank you very much.